Hi, welcome to the webinar on OBIE directory integration. I'm Ashirvada Dharatna, a software engineer from the WSO2 Open Banking team. This is the agenda for the today's webinar. Payment Service Directive, also known as PSD2, requires banks to provide access to customer data through open APIs. There are several specifications around many countries that cater to the PSD2 requirements. The Open Banking specification in UK is based on auth2 framework with necessary enhancements to ensure safe consumption of data, as security is the most crucial factor in open APIs. Before allowing third-party application providers, known as TPPs, access to consumer financial data, the bank must make sure that the data does not fall into wrong hands. To make sure the applications accessing the data are secure, the applications need to be first registered with the bank. The Open Banking OpenID Dynamic Client Registration Specification version 1.00RC2 is the first version of UK specification released for client registration in Open Banking UK. This specification specifies two mechanisms by which a primary technical contact for a trusted third party may submit a software statement assertion to an account service payment services provider, known as ASPSP, for the purpose of receiving a client credential. This client credential received by the TPP enabled the access to the UK Open Banking APIs on behalf of the ASPSP customer. The two mechanisms mentioned in the specification are dynamic client registration, also known as automated client registration, and manual client registration. The Open Banking Directory, acting as a trust anchor, guarantees the authenticity of the banks as well as the application providers. Both banks and TPPs can register with the directory. Registrants has to go through a process of verifying their identity to register with the Open Banking Directory. The directory issues digital certificates for the purpose of message signing and transport level security. TPPs can obtain a software statement assertion from the directory in order to register with the bank. The TPPs can discover the ASPSPs via the directory, where the details of the banks registered and their available API endpoints are advertised. According to the specification, an ASPSP can allow a TPP to register using either the dynamic client registration endpoint or manually through logging to their developer web portal. For either case, before registering, TPP have to log in to the Open Banking Directory developer portal and download a software statement assertion. I will be discussing about both the mechanisms separately in this webinar. A software statement assertion is a JSON web token containing client metadata about an instance of the TPP client software. The JWT is issued and signed by the Open Banking Directory. The payload of an Open Banking SSA must be a compliant software statement according to the RFC 7591 specification. Also, the payload of an Open Banking SSA must be a compliant JWT according to the RFC 7519 specification. You can see a sample SSA here. In this SSA, the details of the TPP is included, all the software roles, software versions they are supporting and the URLs are included in the software statement assertion. First, I'm going to talk about dynamic client registration automated flow. In the automated client registration flow, a TPP can submit a SSA to an ASPSP in exchange for client credentials. These client credentials can be used as a client against an Auth 2.0 authorization server. This is the recommended mechanisms for ASPSP. Before initiating the automated DCI flow, primary technical contact of the TPP should log into the OBIE directory and obtain a SSA. A TPP who wants to register to an ASPSP with the automated flow should send a Auth client registration request including the SSA using a TPP client. Then the dynamic client registration endpoint of the ASPSP will validate the request and register the TPP as a client. And then the dynamic client registration will respond with the client credentials. The TPP must send this request over a mutually authenticated TLS channel. For that, the TPP can use the transport certificates obtained from the OBIE directory. If an ASPSP supports the automated client registration, the ASPSP must operate an RFC 7591 compliant registration endpoint. This endpoint must be protected by transport layer security. This transport layer should be mutually authenticated using certificates chained into OB certificate authority. The endpoint is accepting HTTP POST request, which have a body of application JWT content type. Next, I'm going to talk about the flow of automated client registration with WSO2 OB. As the first step of client registration, TPP should obtain a SSA from the OBIE directory. Then the TPP should send a POST request, including the SSA as a claim in the payload to the client registration endpoint in WSO2 Open Banking. The SSA is sent as a signed JWT which contains the client metadata obtained from the OBIE directory. After receiving the request, WSO2 API manager will validate the request based on the specification. Then an application will be created and will subscribe to all the APIs added in the configuration. Finally, the keys will be generated to the created application and the TPP will be responded with the client credentials. The configurations have to be done to use the WSO2 Open Banking Dynamic Client Registration endpoint. The first configuration is the user have to upload the Open Banking directory root and issuing certificates to the client trustor in both API manager and identity server. Then a new message formatter and a message builder should be added to the access2 XML config file in the API manager home repository conf access2 folder. This is to support the content type of application JWT. After that, to store any properties coming from the SSA, we need to add a server level configuration to the API Manager XML, which resides inside the API Manager home repository conf folder. Following parameters need to be added to the Open Banking XML file, which is inside the AM home repository conf finance folder. The first one should be added is the supported authentication methods for the token endpoint. Next, the connection and read timeout values should be added. Also, all the endpoint URLs to access the REST APIs of API Manager to create applications, service providers, subscribing APIs, generating keys should be added. Also, the user can enable validations for policy client and term of service URIs in the Open Banking XML. Also, a validation can be added for the hostname of policy client logo URIs to match with them match with the hostname of the redirect URI. Also, as I mentioned below in the above slide, the APIs that need to be subscribed should be added in this config file. This is a sample DCR request. It's a post request sent to register endpoint. This is the dynamic client registration endpoint in WSO2 Open Banking. We have to send the content type header as application JWT. This is the decoded registration request which we are sending as the body. Here, all the details of the TPP and the software statement assertion downloaded from the OBIE directory is included. Then, this is the sample response of the registration endpoint. Here, the user will get the client credentials, client ID, and the secret. I will show you a demo on Postman. And here we have added content type application JWT header, and this is the body. Body of the request. We are sending this to the register endpoint. Here is the response and all the details in the SSA in the request are included with the client ID and the client secret. Now, I'm going to talk about the manual client registration flow in version 1.00 RC2. Manual client registration, also known as integration with the OBIE flow, uses OB directory as a federated identity provider to log in to the API store using single sign-on. The TPP needs to be registered with OBIE directory as an AISP, PISP, or CBIIP, and obtain a SSA for a successful login. Also, the authorization grant is used in OIDC flow when using the federated IDP. An ASPSP who support manual registration will offer a developer web portal. If this mechanism is used, the ASPSP must act as a SAML2 or OIDC compliant relying party to Open Banking directory where the PTC or the primary technical contact will be strongly authenticated. So first in the flow, primary technical contact of the TPP should log into the OBIE directory and register as a PSP, PISP, AISP, or CBIIP and download the SSA. Then the TPP will log in to the developer portal of the ASPSP. After logging to the developer web portal of the ASPSP, the ASPSP will send a SSO request to the OBIE directory where the TPP will be redirected to the OBIE login. Upon the successful login of the TPP, ASPSP will receive the SSO response and will send a client credential response to the TPP. Next, I'm going to talk about the flow of manual client registration with WSO2 Open Banking. A user who wants to register to manual client registration with WSO2 Open Banking must first log into the APIM store. Then, after logging to the API Manager store, the user will be redirected to the OB directory login page. Then user have to log to the OB directory login page using the OB credentials. Then the second factor authentication should be authenticated using PIN ID mobile app. Then after successful authentication, user will be logged into APIM store. Then to create an application, user have to paste a valid SSA downloaded from the OBI directory and click on add to the create the application. The configurations that need to be added for manual client registration are as follows. First, the user must create an IDP with the configurations for OBI directory. Then a service provider should be created in WSO2 identity server. Also, we have to update the config changes inside JSON, which resides inside the API Manager home repository deployment server jagreap stores site conf folder. Also, we have to include the attributes which need to be stored in API Manager XML. Then, the key store should be updated with the OB root and issuer certificates. Up to now, I have talked about the OpenID Connect specification for dynamic client registration. The next version of specification released for dynamic client registration is the version 3.1, and currently they have released version 3.2 as well. Dynamic client registration version 3.1 and version 3.2 defines the APIs for the TPP to submit a software statement assertion to an ASPSP for the purpose of creating auth clients. This API supersedes the Open Banking OpenID Connect dynamic client registration profile. The Open Banking Read-Write API standard relies on FAPI Read-Write as a means for authentication of PSU and TPPs. To enable this capacity, a TPP must register one or more clients with the ASPSP. The Dynamic Client Registration API allows this to be carried out in a manner where TPP can easily integrate and interact with the ASPSP. I have included this version 3.1 and version 3.2 specifications in the slides. When we look into the changes in version 3.1 and version 3.2 compared to version 1.00RC2. The first one is the issuers of the SSA in version 1.00, RC2 and version 3.1. In version 1.00RC2, only the OBI directory can issue a SSA. But in version 3.1 and 3.2, other than the OBI directory, TPP itself and another directory service provider can issue SSAs. A SSA signed by the TPP itself is called a self-signed SSA. ASPSP can decide whether they accept or reject these self-signed SSAs. All the other directory providers should be listed in the OBI directory. Only the SSAs from the listed directory providers will be accepted by the ASPSP. When we consider about the authentication, it is divided into two parts based on the request type. For version 1.00RC2, there were only TLS mutual authentication for authenticating. But in version 3.1 and 3.2, for post request, it is TLS mutual authentication, and for get, put and delete request, client credential grant is used as the authentication mechanism. When we look into about the endpoints, in version 1.00RC2, only a post request was introduced. But in version 3.1, get, put and delete endpoints were added to the specification. Among these endpoints, post endpoint is used to register as a client in the ASPSP. Then the get request can be used to get the client credentials. Also, the put request can be used to change the values in the SSA. The delete call is used to delete the client from the ASPSP. Let's jump into DCR version 3.1 with WSO2 Open Banking. For DCR version 3.1 and for version 3.2 also, a separate API is written to expose via API Manager. The APIs mentioned in the previous slide will be routed to an internal API through the gateway level. This is the currently accepted architecture for DCR version 3.1. This will be the same architecture for DCR version 3.2 as well. In this architecture, all the post, get, put, and delete calls will be routed to internal API through the gateway level. We will be including an in sequence to route to internal API. Then the internal API will have three layers, which is API layer, service layer, and DAO layer. In the API layer, the transport certificate will be validated. Also, the headers will be validated. Then the request will be routed to the service layer. In the service layer, the SSA will be validated based on the specification. Then through the service layer, we will be generating access tokens and creating applications, generating keys for the OS application. These things will be done in the service layer. Finally, the DAO layer will save the details coming from the request into the database. When we are talking about release details for DCR version 3.1 and also for version 3.2, currently we are in the process of developing version 3.1, so it will be available before the September deadline. Also, DCR version 3.2 will be available before the September deadline in WSO2 Open Banking Solution. For more information on TPP onboarding with WSO2 Open Banking, you can refer the following documentation. That's all for today's webinar. Thank you for joining us.